So I actually came to Vim from IDEs. So I've used a couple of IDE extensions of Vim in the past. And I'm going to tell you in this video two reasons why I don't really like using these kind of extensions and I just prefer using the real Vim. So the first reason is that a lot of these extensions miss a lot of features that the real Vim has. And one bold example for this is how window splitting works. So if you take a look, I have downloaded for this video especially Visual Studio Code and I installed the most popular Vim extension. It's called VS Code Vim, I think. So if you go ahead and try to split this window, it works fine. You can do Control W and then S. But then let's go ahead and move this window. So I'm going to do Control W and then capital H, for example. Nope, doesn't work. Doesn't move. So you can't move windows. It's not implemented. So this is just a small example of a lot of stuff, a lot of behaviors that are just not implemented in a lot of these extensions. Vim really has a ton of features that are extremely useful, and it's a hard time for all these authors of the various Vim extensions to actually implement them all. So you have a lot of gaps, and these gaps really make the experience of using these extensions very bad. Another example of an annoying gap in this case is if you open, for example, terminal. So you run the term command. You can see the terminal opens fine, right? Let's type in a command, for example. And now let's go ahead and try to switch this into normal mode. So Control W and then N. Oh, it doesn't work as well. And this is a really useful feature on the regular Vim that you have. You can just take any terminal buffer and turn it into normal mode buffer and navigate it. If you want more information, you can just check out my video about window splitting. You got some really cool window splitting features built inside Vim. So these are just small examples of differences in the behavior, but you have a lot of these examples, a lot of missing commands, and it really makes the experience of using these plugins very bad. Just to show you quickly, this is how it works on a real Vim. You can split with Control WS, works fine. You can move the window around with Control W capital H, for example. It also works fine. And when I open up a terminal, I can easily switch to normal mode with Control W and then capital N. The second main reason that I don't like using these extensions is that I don't think they connect very well with the IDE. The IDE has a lot of times its own keyboard shortcuts, its own way of doing stuff. IDEs are very graphical oriented, and Vim has the Vim way of doing stuff, and it really doesn't go well together. And a lot of time these shortcuts collide with the Vim commands. So once you really understand the Vim commands and how they can help you navigate your code, you don't really need all these graphic icons and buttons around here, and you don't need the keyboard shortcuts that the IDEs give you. You can do everything with the Vim commands. So I don't think there's a real purpose to have this kind of hybrid of both. I don't think they work together very well. And I think the main thing that this actually does is confuses you even more, because you're just asking yourself, is this a Vim command or is this a keyboard shortcut of the IDE? Anyway, I think that these extensions can be some kind of solution if you're trying to get into Vim and you're just a beginner, and if you want to take it slowly. But I don't think they are a really long-term solution, because it just doesn't work together. Subscribe for more Vim tips, and thanks for watching.